Good afternoon, everybody. We start with a frightening landing that seemed to be okay at first. The nose gear of a Southwest plane collapsed as the jet touched down at LaGuardia in New York. A handful of passengers and crew had minor injuries, and the cause? It is still under investigation. Now, just feet away, a Laconia woman was on another plane and witnessed the whole thing. Ray Brewer has her story.
The minute it touched down, the nose gear broke off. You saw quite a few sparks.
Laconia resident Robin Rowe was sitting on the tarmac of LaGuardia Airport 5:40 Monday afternoon when Southwest Flight 345 touched down. She was waiting for her flight to take off for Manchester when the event unfolded right outside her plane's windows.
I was kind of stunned that people on the plane with us, there wasn't a lot of commotion when it happened because we all kind of looked around at each other like, did that just happen?
The flight originated in Nashville, and according to the airline, there were 150 people on board the Boeing 737. The passengers said as they were getting ready to land, the plane just nosedived. They also said that prior to taking off in Tennessee, they were told there was some sort of a problem with the tire.
The tire of the nose gear went sailing down the runway past our plane and kind of veered off to the right, and then the plane skidded to a stop. Like, the pilot did a really great job actually getting the plane to stop.
The passengers were forced to exit the plane by emergency chutes as firefighters sprayed the front of the aircraft with foam. A total of 10 passengers were injured, 6 taken to the hospital with what was described as minor injuries.
Now, this latest incident involving a passenger jet comes 16 days after the fatal crash of a Boeing 777 flight from South Korea to San Francisco. So far, Southwest has not issued a statement other than to acknowledge that the incident happened and that they are cooperating in the investigation. A hearing today will decide whether a Massachusetts state trooper will keep his job. He already had a one-day suspension after releasing police photos from the arrest of Boston bombing suspect Jokar Tsarnaev. Sergeant Sean Murphy admitted that he released the photos to Boston Magazine without permission. They showed Tsarnaev covered in blood getting out of the boat where he was hiding in Watertown, Mass. Now, Murphy said he handed over the photos knowing he could lose his job because he was angry about a Rolling Stone cover showing an image of Tsarnaev as a teenager that many believe was glamorizing him. Well, a man spent the night behind bars after police say he tried to rob Red's Shoe Barn in Dover. Officers arrested Wayne Hunter a minute after witnesses reported a man wearing a hoodie entered the store with a knife and demanded money. Authorities say Hunter didn't get away with anything from the store. Concord police are searching for two men who got away after attempting to rob a local Dunkin' Donuts. Police were called to the Fisherville Road location in Penacook just before 4:30 this morning. According to reports, two white males were seen leaving that area on foot. One subject was wearing dark clothes while the other was wearing light-colored clothing. No weapons were shown during the attempt and no one was hurt. Starting tonight at 5, the cash-strapped post office ending door-to-door delivery, maybe. How'd you like to get your mail if a new proposal, how you get your mail if a new proposal passes through Congress? Plus, the first in the fast food business, Taco Bell's stunning decision and the triple effect it could have through the whole industry. That does it for us. Have a great afternoon, everybody.